Symphogear is an anime experience like no other. The final episode of the final season just recently aired, culminating a journey spread across 5 seasons, 63 episodes, countless places across the world, and even the moon. Yes, Symphogear is amazing. But what is Symphogear? How do I describe Symphogear? Well, put simply, Symphogear is Symphogear. That's the best way to put it, and fans of the show will agree with me. But if you're on the outside of the fandom, that means nothing. And yes, I could give you a plot synopsis, but you don't watch this show for the plot. You watch it for being Symphogear. It's like Symphogear is like if JoJo was a magical girl anime. Or if Michael Bay watched an idol anime and decided he wanted to make an anime his way. Or it's like if Twin Tails had a budget and more than one season. Still sad about that one. Or it's like if you combine the insanity of Gurren Lagann with the ideals of shonen anime. Oh, and just like throw in all the lore of the Fate universe too. Actually, that might be the best way to put it. So are you intrigued yet? Or just really confused? Both reactions are very normal for Symphogear. And if you're not sold yet, just go check out the intro for season 3. The link's in the description. There are no spoilers and you will know all you need to. But if you're actually here for something resembling a review for season 5, let's get to that part of the video. From the start of the season, this really felt like the big finale. Symphogear knew it was ending, so they were going all out in pretty much every way. From the story being more or fuller, to the characters all getting their own arcs, the villains of the season were also very interesting in a way that the show had not done before. There's also a lot more done with the lore, and it being more fleshed out and explained. And of course, the animation and music were top-notch, even for Symphogear standards. Plus, the show has my favorite transformation sequences out of all magical girl anime. You know, I sometimes forget this is actually a magical girl anime. Yes, for those who are not aware, this is in fact a magical girl show. The characters gain power through singing and then fight the evil noise or whatever villains there are this season. This season specifically is a direct follow-on from season 4, with the threat that Adam was trying to get the power to stand against now in full focus. So, as expected, the Symphogears need to stop this new threat. But despite this big danger, the best part of the season's stories come through those smaller stories. We get a trio of new villains, Noble Red, who are my favorite villains of the show. And unlike most of the villains so far, they're far weaker than the Symphogears, along with even last season's villains. I really like this for several reasons. First, it's something different. Normally in action shows like this, there's a constant power escalation, but instead here, they took a step back, which was refreshing. Plus, it forced the villains to be underdogs. There's a certain draw to wanting to root for underdogs in storytelling, so that made me want to root for the villains. Plus, I could really feel the desperation Noble Red had, which was great. It made it so that the villains had to use more unconventional tactics, which made the battles more exciting. They got a lot of interesting development too, though I don't want to spoil exactly how that all worked. But while they are doing obviously villainous things, we understand why in their twisted way of viewing things. And in their twisted way of doing things, they are doing the only thing that they can. Hibiki and the rest of the heroes keep reaching out to them, trying to bring them to their side, but the villains constantly reject that offer. Granted, they weren't the only villains this season, but they are the ones I like the best. Though the other two have their own interesting aspects and desires, which make them also interesting in their own way. The character arcs of the heroes were also very interesting. While some of them definitely got more focused than others, they all had some way to feel like their story was being wrapped up. Like, yeah, the Death Lollies, fully feeling like they've overcome their past and are now wanting to reach out to others who were in the same place that they were not that long ago. Plus, you also have their childish side too, which is always fun to see. Then you have Hibiki's relationship with Miku and also her father. And then, of course, Tsubasa's relationship with her own father and grandfather. That's actually one of the big ideas throughout the season. The characters' relationships with their family, specifically the father. Many of these relationships have been strained, but at times they're able to repair these bonds, though other times there's no resolution. I really like seeing this dynamic explored through all the different characters. The story itself for the season was the most ambitious one yet, and I would say the best yet, though it wasn't perfect. The thing about Symphogear is that it's not about the story. It's about the fun. The story is just an excuse to have as much fun as possible. But this season is different. They really did try to make the story as full and as good as they could, and it was great. There are lots of twists, big moments, though it still embodied all the fun of the previous season. There are times where the show felt a bit rushed that they were trying to cram so much into the few episodes that they had, but it wasn't too bad. There are also some times where all the lore and plot made the show kind of confusing, or at least more complicated than I felt it needed to be, but I do appreciate how well thought out the magical backdrop is for the show. Plus, this season is super self-aware. That's really one of the things that makes Symphogear so great. It knows the exact type of show it is and is able to embrace its serious storytelling and all the suspenseful plot there with its ridiculousness and embracing the fun of everything. It can push the plot in ways that would be a detriment to most other shows, but it ends up working as a plus for Symphogear. A great example. This guy is driving a car trying to escape from Noble Red. Vanessa fires some missiles at his car and it's about to hit, but he dodges them using a car clone jutsu. This is completely stupid, ridiculous, and awesome. Like, yes, that guy is a ninja. Not the first time I've seen that, though I do wish we got him to fight more. Or there is a time where IT professionals all across the globe, rallied by Donald Trump, come together to help save the world. Like, what other show would think of that? Plus, there are way too many lines that I just had to screenshot. Sometimes they make sense in context, but many times they do not. You know, this show is fan service, especially this season. This season is fan service for fans of Symphogear. It's like they asked fans what they wanted for a final season, and then gave them that, and then some stuff they did not even know that they wanted. Like, we actually got the commander fighting, and it was great. And then her. Like, who thought that she would be back? Or be that awesome. And I loved how the show kept drawing on the previous seasons to bring it all together. We especially got that in the final episode, but all throughout the season it was constantly pulling from the past, tying everything into this big finale. Through the characters we saw, the different events, or even ideas were all brought together here, and it was fantastic. I also love the references to other anime. Some are more subtle than others, but you can tell that the makers of the show really are anime fans. Especially of Gurren Lagann and JoJo. And Evangelion, especially Evangelion, and maybe Independence Day too. Symphogear is like a celebration of the ridiculous action shows that came before it. There is a darker side of anime storytelling that's more cynical, especially when you get into the magical girl shows, but Symphogear is a loud response to embrace the ideas of the genre. Not to say the show doesn't get dark, because it does, but the show is filled with hope. I haven't even gotten to talk about the great production values yet, and that's in a way the most important part. The animation is great, and there is at least one battle every episode, sometimes multiple ones. Plus, there is that concert performance in episode 2 that might just be the best musical performance I've seen in anime. This isn't even an idol anime, and it put most idol anime to shame. Actually, I should do a full topic on that video. That's a good idea. Someone remind me about that when I'm not writing a script for a Symphogear video at 1 in the morning. That explains a lot about the script. Anyway, the music. Oh, the music. Pretty much every battle had an insert song sung by one or more of the characters, and they turn a great action scene into what is basically a great MV. The songs are fantastic just to listen to, and I have been doing so while writing the script. Again, that explains a lot. Seriously, just go look up the songs on Spotify, their Symphogear Wiki. They're super distracting when trying to write a script, but I feel it'd be wrong to make a video on the show while not listening to the music. I like the lyrics too, since they give us a greater understanding of the characters, or they just have these great fun lines. But I also love how the songs are filled with power and encouragement. Especially this season, many of the songs are about overcoming the hard times in life. Like, Kiriki has a lyric in one of her songs about how overcoming everything has caused her tears to be stars. And then Shirobe has a similar line, but it's about her history becoming stars. I just love that imagery. It's space. It's cool. I love space. And speaking of things I love, there's a ton to love about Symphogear, and this season in particular. It very well could have been the final season, though after a season like that, I want more. It combines absurd and ridiculous fun with a gripping story and a cast of great characters. And really, I don't think any other show does what Symphogear does better. So I highly recommend it. Yeah, the first seasons were a bit rough, especially compared to this most recent one, but I still recommend trying it, especially if you're a fan of the other shows I talked about, like Gurren Lagann or JoJo. I think you'll find something really special here. And tell me, what other shows have you found are like Symphogear? That's actually a topic I'd like to explore in another week or two, so keep an eye out for that video. Anyway, thank you everyone for watching and for listening to me rant about Symphogear. And join me next week for, I never know what I'm doing next week, but join me for that, and I will talk to you then.